This morning in Hancock Field News, airstrikes continue against terrorists from ISIL and the Air Force leads the fight. Plus, 174th leadership meets to discuss objectives for 2015. And a mass accident response exercise is conducted on Hancock Field with local authorities. The latest news around Hancock Field starts right now. Good morning, Hancock Field. I'm Sergeant Eric Miller.
And I'm Airman Sarah Schreiber, and welcome to the October UTA.
Well, summer is over.
Yes, it is, and it's been another busy month for the 174th and the United States military.
U.S. military forces continue to attack ISIL terrorists in Iraq and Syria using a mix of fighter, attack, and remotely piloted aircraft to conduct airstrikes. Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel recently told reporters defeating the Islamic State of Iraq and Levant will require a long-term commitment by the United States and its allies on many fronts.
They're beyond just a terrorist group. They marry ideology, a sophistication of strategic and tactical military prowess. They are tremendously well-funded. Oh, this is beyond anything that we've seen.
Terrorism is an enduring threat to each of us. The use of social media and online forums by foreign terrorist organizations has increased significantly, especially following the airstrikes on ISIL and the Al-Qaeda-affiliated Khorasan group. Maintaining situational awareness and remaining vigilant is our best defense. Leaders and supervisors must ensure all New York military members, families, and employees understand the threat and emphasize the importance of timely and accurate suspicious activity reporting.
On September 10th, the 174th conducted a mass accident response exercise in conjunction with local police, fire, and emergency services. 174th Mission Support Commander John O'Connor spoke with us about the importance of the exercise.
Every time we do this, we test our ability to communicate with the different agencies. There's 17 different agencies that we're working with, and we're ready to work with those agencies every day, but we need to test our ability to talk with them, that our equipment can be used with theirs, and that we have the ability to respond with them when needed. So we test that procedure. This is a safe way to test it. We find out if we can do that job and do it well. So you can see that whole response start to finish, from the accident starting and the fire and explosions, to the treatment of the victims, to the check of the area, to the security of the area, and then to the conclusion of the exercise.
The annual tag match was held back in June and required participants to employ the weapons used on the battlefields of Iraq and Afghanistan. One team is awarded the championship trophy, and this year it was Team Reaper bringing home the hardware. Congratulations to the 174th Rifle Team, and you can read more about it in the summer edition of the Guard Times.
Each year from 15 September to 15 October, Americans observe National Hispanic Heritage Month by celebrating the history, culture, and contributions of the Hispanic population. Hispanics and Latinos have fought in the United States military in every major military conflict from the American Revolution.
If you look at the last 10 years, 12 years of war, and you really dig down and look at the contributions of Hispanics, you're going to see that they've participated in every operation. And they've done so with distinction, and they've done so with honor, and they'll continue to do so.
This past month, Colonel Scott Brenton moved to the Wing Headquarters staff, and Lieutenant Colonel Eric Susie became the Interim Operations Group Commander.
The Fort Drum bus tour was a big hit this past month, as unit members took a day to see 174th attack wing operations going on daily out of Fort Drum. We talked to the 174th Command Chief to see why he coordinates this trip.
I love to bring men and women up here that never had a chance or don't realize that this is going on within their organization. Then they get to realize, first off, how far maintenance has to travel every day to get an MQ-9 in the air, and how we're training the sensor operators and the pilots, and what has to go into that in a daily routine. Trying to get that stuff to work every day safely. It's a good team building event, and it builds some pride. Now that's part of my goal right there. The aircraft were great, the timing was great, and I think we've had, of all the times we've come up, this was the largest group. So we had 35, 36 people this time, and we'll try to do it again in October, and I hope everybody on the bus goes back and tells anybody in their shop how much fun they had and how they felt at the end of the day. Maybe next time we'll have 45 people on the bus.
A revamp in the Air Expeditionary Force construct started this past Wednesday, October 1st. The new design looks to deploy more airmen with their units and standardized dwell times across the Air Force. ACC Commander General Mike Hostage spoke to airmen in Southwest Asia about the change.
The AF Next construct is designed to get everyone on that six-month cycle. It also is designed to get units to go en masse as opposed to individuals out of a unit. And because we're sending the whole unit, they'll already know how to work within the unit.
Master Sergeant Patrick DiCrasto, a technical air control party specialist here at the 174th, was recently highlighted for his work in the Air National Guard and as a detective with the Syracuse Police Special Investigations Division. Check out the article on Airmen Magazine's website or on the 174th Facebook page.
Family Fun Run registration is still available today from 11 to 1300 at both entrances of the DFAC. The Fun Run is a 1.5-mile run for unit members and their families to promote fitness and a good time.
Air crews from the 107th Airlift Wing in Niagara Falls flew their final C-130 flight on September 25th. The unit is in the process of converting from the C-130 to the MQ-9 Reaper. The unit is on course to be fully operational by 2017.
As the worst Ebola outbreak in history unfolds in West Africa, airmen deploy to support humanitarian relief operations. Airmen will set the stage for further mission success by standing up the Expeditionary Medical Support System and training public health professionals on the proper use of equipment.
On Sunday, October 5th at 1445, the 174th Formal Training Unit will be officially recognized as a 108th Attack Squadron. Lieutenant Colonel John Knutson will assume command of the 108th.
Fire prevention officials say to test your smoke alarms every month, and when a smoke alarm sounds, get outside and stay out. This year's theme is Working Smoke Alarms Save Lives. Visit the National Fire Protection Association website for more fire safety tips.
October 31st is the deadline for SGLI reimbursement for eligible members. The reimbursement applies to all AGRs. The SGLI rate change took effect on July 1st, 2014, changing the max deductible from $27 to $29 per month.
This past month, citizen emergency preparedness training has been taking place throughout New York State. The training provides tools and resources to prepare for any type of disaster. There are two more training sessions taking place in our area. Check out the New York State Prepare website for more information.
With midterm elections right around the corner, the Adjutant General of New York, Major General Patrick Murphy, encourages military members to exercise their right to participate in our political process. However, political activity for Guard members can be problematic, as many restrictions that apply to the full-time force do not apply to traditional Guardsmen. If you have any questions, contact the Staff Judge Advocate or the Government Affairs Office before engaging in any political activity.
The 7th Annual Central New York Parade and Expo will be at the New York State Fairgrounds on November 8th. For those that want to represent the 174th, contact 2nd Lieutenant Devin Will no later than October 17th. Paid military duty status is authorized.
If you are interested in supporting a surge effort in the New York metropolitan area and working with Task Force Empire Shield, please visit the New York Division of Military and Naval Affairs job website and apply.
New ancillary training requirements through ARCNET will be presented by security forces immediately following commander's comments. The Public Affairs SharePoint page has this training video available for download and the CCTV schedule of training.
Leaders from across Hancock Field joined together at Clear Path for Veterans this past month for the off-base summit. The agenda for the day covered a wide variety of topics and brainstorming the wing's objectives for fiscal year 2015. The New York Air National Guard Command Chief was also in attendance to talk to 174th leadership.
You know, we worry about the budget, and we talk about that, but I think this is a unique year for airmen to continue their professional development and their education. Chief Hotelling pushes this down from the Air National Guard Command Chief position, and the message is received loud and clear at the wings that we're going to develop our airmen in a correct way, and I think that's the biggest goal for 15.
Medical appointments will be available on Saturday and Sunday of UTA from 0830 to 1100. Contact your UHM for scheduling of appointments. And flu shots have arrived. Check your email that went out to members from Chief Ramsey for more information.
And some major changes to the way we currently get reimbursed for expenses when we travel. There are many reimbursements that are no longer allowed. These expenses will be included as part of a daily incidental expense rate, which is part of your per diem. The Compass Rose has more information, as well as the Finance CPTF SharePoint page.
The 174th's Facebook page reached a new milestone with over 1,000 followers and continues to grow. Thank you to our followers for staying engaged on the latest news out of Hancock Field. Thousands of historic photos from 1940 to present have been recently added, and many more to come.
And that's your UTA Weekend Update.
Have a great drill, everybody.